In this lecture, we will discuss residue. So, the contents are we will recall Lorentz series and we will define what is residue and we will do some problems based on residue. So, let us recall first, let us recall what is Lorentz series. So what is Lorentz series? Suppose f of z is analytic inside an annular region. That means if you have a domain like this, so if f of z is analytic here in this annular region, and it need not be analytic anywhere else. This is suppose z naught. Okay. So, it need not be analytic at the center. So now we can annular region, I am taking mod z r1 minus mod z minus z naught less than r2. So this is the radius of r1 and this is the radius of the circle, second circle c1 c2. Okay, so then f of z can be represented as Lorentz series of the form f of z is equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity a n z minus z naught all power n plus sigma n equal to 0 to infinity b n divided, sorry, 1 to infinity b n divided by z minus z naught all power n, where r1 less than mod z minus z naught less than r2. Okay, so this is called Lorentz series. Now we know that what is singularity. So a point z equal to z naught is said to be a singular point. Singular point if f of z is not analytic at a z naught. Now our aim is to find a residue of a function. So residue we will define at the singular points. Okay, so before residue, so for definition of residue, let f of z is a singularity at z equal to z naught. So the z naught is a singular point. Let the Lorentz series expansion of f of z with the center z naught is of the form f of z, that is Lorentz series of the form sigma n equal to 0 to infinity a n z minus z naught all power n plus sigma n equal to 1 to infinity b n divided by z minus z naught all power n, and we are taking in the region 0 less than mod z minus z naught less than r. That means immediate neighborhood of z naught. So for residue we will take the Lorentz series expansion in this neighborhood. Okay, 0 less than mod z minus z naught less than. then okay, so if we expand this, we will get a naught plus a1 z minus z naught plus a2 z minus z naught all square plus etc. Now this is a Taylor series part and this is a principal part. So for principal part plus etc. plus b1 divided by z minus z naught plus b2 divided by z minus z naught all square plus etc. So this is principal part. Now the coefficient. Okay, so now I will define what is residue. The coefficient of 1 by z minus z naught is called residue of f at z naught. So what is the coefficient of 1 by 1 z minus z naught? This is b1. Therefore b1 is equal to residue of, we will write in the expression as of the form z equal to z naught, residue of z equal to z naught f of z. So this is called residue of z naught at f of z at z naught. So the coefficient, if we find the coefficient b1, then that will be the residue of f of z. Now why this is important? So that is our question, why this coefficient is important. Now suppose suppose f of z is not analytic at z naught and the Lorentz series expansion f of z is equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity a n z minus z naught all power n plus sigma n equal to 0, 1 to infinity b n divided by z minus z naught all power n for 0 less than mod z minus z naught less than r. R is some radius of the circle of convergence. So this can be written as f of z a naught z minus z, sorry, a naught plus a1 z minus z naught plus a2 z minus z naught all square plus etc. And now what is the principal part? B1 by z minus z naught plus b2 by z minus z naught all square plus etc. Now suppose we have a curve. So suppose f of z is analytic. So suppose this is z naught and this is curve C, and suppose f of z is analytic everywhere except at z naught. So if we have a function f of z which is analytic everywhere in the circle except at the point z naught, then if we want to find the integral over C f of z dz, this is equal to integral over C. What is f of z? F of z is a naught. You take the Lorentz series expansion. A1 z minus z naught plus etc. plus b1 by z minus z naught plus b2 by z minus z naught all square plus etc. Now I will take here. So what we will do is, okay, if you integrate this, this you can split into integral over C a naught dz plus integral over C a1 z minus z naught dz plus etc. plus integral over c v1 divided by z minus z0 dz plus integral over c v2 divided by z minus z0 all square plus etc. Now what will happen here? So a0 is a constant. So and our a0 is a constant function, and the f of and therefore it is analytic. So a constant function is always analytic, and if you integrate along a closed curve by Cauchy integral theorem, what will be the answer? This will be zero. Now what happened here? This is also analytic everywhere, therefore that integral must be zero. So every terms in Lorentz series part, that those integral will be zero, right? Now what happened here? So I am putting here this here integral over c b1 z minus z0 dz plus. Now what will happen these terms? B2 z minus z0 all square plus it. So now and integral over c b3 z minus z0 all cube plus etc. Now what will happen here for this integral? So that for that integral, integral over c b2 by z minus z0 all square dz, and we know that the f of z is analytic everywhere except at z0. So we can use Cauchy integral theorem for derivatives. So what will happen? So here f of z is, so this f of z is b2. So here you will get 2 pi I into f dash of by 1 factorial f dash of z0. So what is derivative of b2? This is a constant, therefore this become 0, right? So what will happen here? Here also the numerator is constant, so this becomes 0. So every terms in the principal part except this term, this integral is 0. So our integral now change into integral over c b2, sorry, b1 divided by z minus z0 dz. Now what is this? So we can use Cauchy integral formula. So by Cauchy integral formula, here it is f of z is equal to b1, then what is the answer? 2 pi I into f of z0. So this is always a constant, so this is b1. Hence therefore integral over c f of z dz must be equal to 2 pi I into b1. So what is b1? Residue. So therefore integral over c f of z dz must be equal to 2 pi I into residue of z equal to z0 at the f of z. So that's why the integration is residue integration is very important. So residue is very important. This b1 is very important. Now if you want to calculate the integral of a function, you can find by using residue. Okay. So have you got it? So let me explain once more so that you will get an idea. So what we have done, so we have a function which is not analytic at z0, then we find the Lorentz series immediate neighborhood, Lorentz series expansion, sigma n equal to 0 to infinity a n z minus z0 all power n plus sigma 1 to infinity p n by z minus z0 all power n. So I am expanding this and Now, if we have, suppose the function is analytic everywhere, except at z naught in some curve C. Okay. So, integral over C f of z dz is integral over C of a naught plus a1 z, z minus z naught plus etc. plus b1 z minus z naught. A1 divided by z minus z naught, B2 divided by z minus z naught all square, etc. Now, we will integrate this separately. So, integral over C A naught dz, integral over C A1 z minus z naught dz plus integral over C A2 z minus z naught all square plus etc. So, these all are analytic. These functions are analytic. Therefore, by Cauchy integral theorem, this becomes 0. Now, what happened here? So, I will put this here. And for the 3 divided. So, here, the numerator part is a constant. B2, B3, etc. Then, by Cauchy integral theorem for derivatives, this becomes, this integral all becomes 0. So, what will be the remaining? Remaining integral over C f of z dz is equal to integral over C b1 divided by z minus z naught dz. And what is that integral? By Cauchy integral formula 2 pi I into f of z naught. So, f of z naught is b1. So, the integral is changed into 2 pi I into b. So now our aim is to find out how to find out residue of function. If we know residue of a function, then the integration becomes very easy. So now we will. Okay. So first question: integrate f of z is equal to z raised to minus 4. Same z counterclockwise around a unit circle. So, if you get a problem based on integration, the first thing you have to do is you have to draw the curve. So, here our curve is unit circle. So, what is unit circle? Unit circle is a circle with a center 0 and radius 1. So, this is our center and radius is. Now, we have given f of z is equal to 1 by z raised to 4 sin z is analytic everywhere except at z equal to 0. So, denominator becomes 0 when z equal to 0. So, everywhere except z equal to 0, f of z has is analytic. Now we will find the Lorentz series expansion. Now we will find Lorentz series expansion of sine z divided by z raised to 4. So we already know the Maclaurin series of sine z. Then z is z minus z cubed by 3 factorial plus z raised to 5 by 5 factorial plus etc. minus etc. This is valid everywhere. More z less than. Now. For. So this is not defined at 0. So for 0 less than mod z less than infinity. Or you can write mod z greater than 0. The Lorentz series expansion, of f of z is, that means Lorentz series expansion of sin z divided by z raised to 4 is equal to, okay, so what is that? 1 by z raised to 4 into, because we have to, here the singularity is 0, so we have to expand in terms of z minus 0. Okay, so this is z minus z cube by 3 factorial plus z raised to 5 by 5 factorial minus z raised to 7 by 7 factorial plus z raised to 9 by 9 factorial minus etc. And this is valid when mod z 0 less than mod z less than infinity. So this is equal to 1 by z cube minus if you 1 by z into okay minus 1 by 3 factorial into 1 by z plus z by 5 factorial minus z raised to 3 by 7 factorial plus etc. Now what is residue? Residue of f of z, that is residue, we will denote residue at z equal to 0, f of z is equal to coefficient of 1 by z. So what is the coefficient of 1 by z? So this is 1 by z, its coefficient is 1 by 3 factorial. So this is 1 by 6. So residue is 1 by 6. Now what we have to do is we have to, so what is our question? Integrate along the unit circle, right? So what we will do is we will integrate. We got residue, so integral is got residue. So we have to integrate integral over c sin z divided by z raised to 4 dz is equal to, we know that 2 pi I into residue of, because there is only one singular point and analytic everywhere except residue of z equal to 0 f of z. So this is equal to 2 pi I into 1 by residue is 1 by 6, this is equal to pi I by 3. So this is the answer. Okay. So it now the integration becomes very easy while if we are doing. Now what we will do is we will do one more problem. So here the question is integrate f of z equal to 1 by z cube minus z raised to 4 clockwise around the circle mod z equal to 1 by 2. So now what we will do is first we will draw the circle. So here, what is our circle? C is mod z equal to 1 by 2. So the center is 0, radius 1 by 2. So this is our circle. Now, f of z is equal to 1 by, this you can return as z cube into 1 minus z is analytic everywhere except at z equal to 0 and z equal to 1. So now we will note z equal to 0 is here and z equal to 1 is here. So z equal to 1 is, this is outside, right? So we will not consider it as a singularity. So therefore, f of z is equal to 1 by z cube, 1 minus z is analytic everywhere except at z equal to 0 in where in this curve C. Now we will find residue. So what we will do is 1 by z cube into 1 minus z. This can be written as 1 by z cube into 1 by 1 minus z. So this we can written as 1 by z cube. 1 by 1 minus z is 1 plus z square plus z cube plus z raised to 4 plus etc. And this is valid when 0 less than mod z less than 1. So this is valid when mod z less than 1 and we have 0 is a singularity. So we will expand this 1 by z cube plus 1 by z square plus 1 by z plus 1 plus z plus etc. when 0 less than mod z less than 1. So here singularity is 0. So therefore residue is equal to residue of f of z at z equal to 0 is equal to coefficient of 1 by z. So what is coefficient of 1 by z? So 1 by z in the coefficient is 1. Therefore residue is equal to 1. Now integral over c 1 by z cube into 1 minus z dz is equal to 2 pi I into residue of z equal to 0 f of z. So this is 2 pi I into 1. So now the integration becomes very easy. Okay. So on the next class we will discuss more about residues and residue integration. Okay, so let us conclude.